In just a few hours, NASA's Artemis mission will mark a major milestone as its Orion spacecraft moves into orbit around the moon. The uncrewed capsule has already been sending back incredible close-up photos of the lunar surface like nothing we've ever seen before. Joining me now, NASA Administrator Bill Nelson. So my eye is untrained, but you, as a former astronaut who have seen a lot more than most, and obviously being the NASA Administrator, know a little bit more. What do you make of these photos?
Well, the photos are incredible, but what is even more incredible is the fact that this is a test flight that we have stressed and tested before we put humans on board, and everything seems to be working. And when the little things come up, as they always do, this incredible team is able to change whatever needs to be changed to overcome the problem. So we are now going on a position 40,000 miles beyond the moon, further than any human-rated spacecraft has ever been. And then the orbit's going to be circularized. They're going to do one full orbit and then start the deorbit process, use the moon's gravity to slingshot us back all the way to Earth, splash down December the 11th, right off of San Diego.
So was there a kind of, and pardon me for being very simplistic here, but a kind of checklist that said, okay, these are the things we need to learn to find out before we actually put humans back on board and send them to the moon? And what were some of the priorities from this mission to make sure you were able to move on to the next one?
Well, of course, the heat shield has to work. That's 5,000 degrees coming in. It's hot. It's fast. It's 32 Mach, which is about 25,000 miles an hour when it encounters the Earth's atmosphere. So clearly one of the major tests of this flight is that that heat shield's got to work. But all the other things, the rocket had to work. It worked beautifully. Now the adjustments to the trajectory as we go around the moon, the checking out of the human-rated spacecraft, all of that's going on in 2024. Four humans, four NASA astronauts are going to climb on the top of that baby and strap in. And here we go, 8.8 million pounds of thrust at liftoff.
I'm totally unqualified, but I volunteer. Having said that, understanding it's not going to happen, are you at all concerned about there's a new Congress coming in? There is the reality. You operated in the congressional milieu for many, many years. You know how it works. You know how bipartisanship or lack thereof can also work. Do you feel confident about support for the space program going forward?
I'm really not, because we have support from ours and these alike. We are reflective of the American people, and what do they want? They want success. They want America to come together to stop this divided nation. And interestingly, our space program is a place that that happens. So it's not only bipartisan, it's nonpartisan. But more than that, look at the international community. This is not America alone. We have international partners. A major portion of this spacecraft is the European service module. When we go on to the moon and when we set up a lunar space station, it will be participated in by many nations. And again, in the international arena, where we also have difficulty, obviously, with Russia and China, we have been able to have these nations come together. I might say not with China, with Russia since 1975.
Well, we are going to watch this as it moves forward, both this mission and the return of man to the moon. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson, thank you for being with us. We appreciate it.